All right, hello everyone. Three words aren't enough here, and today I'm going to be doing a speed build for The Sims 4. I've never done a video like this. I'll be quite honest, I don't really build in The Sims 4. I mainly just record and sometimes play with The Sims 4, but I really wanted to just get more skills with building in general, so I thought that this would be a good opportunity to really just practice some of the basic techniques of building a house. The reason why I went with a starter home is because I think it's a lot easier when you're learning to do smaller houses, just because you don't have to worry about, you know, fitting roofs onto so many large components. Plus, you can also just, you know, you don't have to fill up so much space when you're furnishing the house as well, so that's really helpful because I suck at furnishing and I suck at building, so yeah, it was just a great way to practice both of these things with a small house. Right now, as you can see, I'm trying to fit like a cute little awning onto the roof, but I was trying to do it with two and it was just looking really cluttered. So yeah, I'm just trying to play around, and eventually, as you can see right now, I'm trying to do like just one single awning to see how it looks, and it really doesn't look that bad, so I decided to go with it in the end and attach a cute little gable roof onto that. I'm trying to mess around more with the roof. It's really difficult in The Sims 4 to do roofing. In The Sims 3 it was so easy because you could just hit auto roof and you would have a great roof, no problem, but with this game it's definitely more difficult to get a roof that doesn't look like crap. And right now, like, I'm trying to mess around with the roof in the back there, but it's clipping on the bottom, which is just really annoying. So I'm just kind of playing around trying to see if I can get a different roof to fit. But yeah, I couldn't really find anything that looked somewhat decent or that wouldn't clip in general. So as you'll see pretty soon, I end up actually just going with the gabled roof, but reducing the amount that it goes downwards just so that it doesn't clip with the bottom, which is a little unfortunate because I do like, you know, how it looks when it does extend a bit downwards, but hey, I will absolutely take what I can get with this game. Yeah, so I noticed in the back there that I kind of forgot to add a roof to the where the two columns are, but I do fix that eventually. Right now I'm trying to add some windows onto the little awning, and it was really weird. Like, I couldn't find a good window that would like fit in the center. And what I found is that I was able to like move windows up and down, but I can't really move them left and right however I want, even when I'm pressing Alt and all that. So if you know what I'm supposed to do there, definitely let me know. But yeah, I was having a lot of trouble trying to find a window that, you know, filled enough space but also, you know, didn't fill up too much space or it was extending over the roof. So eventually I just settled on those base game windows right there, just because I felt like it looked the most natural. It wasn't too big, not too small, it was just right. I'm just adding some more windows here, again, sticking to base game content because I really wanted this this stuff to, you know, you can just download it and you don't have to have a certain stuff pack or certain game pack or whatever. So really trying hard to use only base game content. Sometimes I mess up and just use, you know, stuff from other packs just because I've had these packs for so long. So I'm not really used to, you know, I don't really look at what pack they're associated with. I just kind of use them all the time and then I get comfortable using these things. So yeah, it really was difficult to just use base game content. Right now, yeah, I'm just remembering to add a roof, and then I noticed that it didn't really look good. It looked a bit too messy, so I decided to just remove those columns in general and just have it be like a little sit-down porch, which I think turned out a lot nicer. And yeah, in the front there, I still need to do the roof on that section just because I forgot. This build is definitely not very organized. I'm kind of going back and forth. I'm not really sure. Like, I'm not following it procedurally. Like, I'm not just doing windows and then I'm moving on to something else. I just kind of, I get distracted as I'm building and then I like notice that I should fix something there and then I go back and fix that. Then I get sidetracked again. So yeah, I definitely should work on just being focused. But here you can see I'm trying to add that roof and I think it came out pretty nice. I don't really use those sideways, or sorry, the diagonal roofs in general. So I liked having to, I liked playing around with that, and I think that adding the little awning on the roof made that roof, like the extra roof I added, not look as weird. I keep trying to add more windows in the front just because I feel like the front needs more. Like, it needs more light, it needs more windows. I really have a bad habit of just adding too many windows and it really looks bad. So yeah, I'm trying to figure out like what should I add to make it not look terrible, but I can't really figure it out. So I just move on to do the floors and eventually I'll clue in and I'll realize that, yeah, I'll just add some more windows and see how it goes. Yeah, you can see right there, I'm adding those windows to try and make the house look a little more complete, I should say. So I guess as I'm painting the house right now with, or I guess not painting, but adding the siding, I just want to give a quick update on my content. So I am still working on Nadine. If you've been checking my social media, I've been filming quite regularly. I just started my master's, so I was really busy with the move because I moved to a whole different province. So yeah, now that I'm settled, I'm like getting more into filming, which is pretty nice and pretty exciting. Some of my voice actors are still working on their lines, so I'm hoping to get those in soon just so I can start editing some of the scenes. But yeah, I'm not giving up on the series or anything. I'm definitely dedicated towards, you know, getting that done and really having something else to showcase out of my work. Another thing too is I would like to expand on this channel. Like, I don't want to just do machinima. I don't want to just focus on one series. Like, I'd like to have some more content going on, like perhaps doing the occasional speed build or doing like a let's play. Like, I'd like to kind of play around with my channel and see what else I can do. Just because I think it's getting a little mundane to just do the same kinds of videos over and over again. So yeah, I think it would be refreshing to just have the opportunity to work on other projects simultaneously. Right now, I'm starting to work on the inside. I was having a lot of trouble trying to get a good layout just because this house is so tiny and you really need to cram a lot of stuff into a small space. So I think for me the bedroom was the biggest struggle because I really wanted to have a double bed in there, just, you know, thinking that maybe there was a couple staying here or something like that, or, you know, if you want to bring back a friend to woohoo with in The Sims. But yeah, it wasn't looking nice, so I eventually just opted out to have a single bed. And Sims will just have to go somewhere else to woohoo if they want to, or you can edit this lot as you see fit. But yeah, and I decided to use that little corner over there for the bathroom just because it was like a good section and there weren't any like big windows there, so it was a good place to just put like a shower, sink, and, you know, the necessities over there. But yeah, going back to what I was saying earlier, if you guys, I guess, have any recommendations or you like really want to see me do something on this channel, please let me know, because I'd really like to do more with this channel instead of just doing machinima. And, you know, I'd like to get more content out there because I think it's fun. I like uploading to YouTube. So yeah, if you have anything in particular you want me to do, like if you want, I guess, like a behind the scenes video, or you just wanted me to do like a let's play. I was thinking, going off on a tangent, but I was thinking it would be fun if we took like some of the characters from my series that maybe didn't get as much of an ending. So people like Annabelle, Dahlia, like those kinds of characters, and we can maybe do a let's play with them just so we can see their story continue on. Obviously it's not going to be like quote unquote canon, but I think it could be fun. But yeah, just let me know if that kind of stuff is interesting to you. I know that you guys probably follow a lot of simmers, so yeah, I don't want to just do like the same thing everyone else is doing. I definitely would like to do something a little different. Right now I'm just trying to find a place to put all of these bedroom items, because in that corner, like, it's a nice spot to put a dresser. And you can put like a mirror on the wall, which looks nice. But then on the opposite wall, I wanted to have the kitchen there, and it just, having that door in that location just really ruins the flow of it because you can't have as many counters. So yeah, I was just trying to play around. I thought I could add a desk there, but it was just looking like really cluttered. And like, obviously it's gonna look cluttered because it's a smaller house, but yeah, I was just trying to make it look not crap. I think that's the motto of this whole build, make it not look like crap. Yeah, so just adding some more touches here. I'm just furnishing the bathroom because I wanted to make sure that everything could fit and that Sims could access it all. I actually do end up moving that sink there because I tested it out with a Sim and the Sim could not access the mirror or the sink. So I did end up moving it against that opposite wall there, as you'll see when I do like a little preview section at the end. Right now I'm just adding some counters for the kitchen, and as you can see here, I'm just remodeling the bedroom after discovering that the door was going to ruin everything. But yeah, I think that the kitchen came out pretty nice. Like, it's very tiny, but it has like everything that you could need in a kitchen. You have some places to sit, you have counter space, you have the stove, like fridge, everything that you could need is there. I decided to make that bedroom smaller just so you could have more space on that opposite wall, so you could put stuff like a bookshelf or a garbage can to, yeah, just so that there's more space, because that space in the bedroom wasn't really being used, it was just kind of there, so I decided to just get rid of that in general. Just finishing the kitchen right now, and then I'm soon going to move on to do the living room area, and I just, I had a lot of trouble trying to do the living room because I really wanted to use these new couches that they had in the latest patch. So for those of you who don't know, they added some new items in a recent patch. So they added like a couple new, or not a couple, they added a new hair, they added some men and women's shirts, an outfit for children, and they added a few like chairs and stuff like that. So I really wanted to incorporate that. But it just, the couch wouldn't fit. It was too big for me to use in such a tiny house. So I was trying to use that, but that just didn't work. So I eventually just went with the standard cheapest love seat I could find. Now I'm just adding the TV, and I use the move objects on cheat to raise that TV. And yeah, my my computer kind of bugged out because I was trying to raise that using the move objects on cheat, but it just got confused and just showed me the sky. But yeah, I was definitely trying to do that, not successfully, but it did happen eventually, so that's great. I'm adding like a little study area because it wouldn't fit in the bedroom, so I'm just trying to add that in to give it, I guess to fill in a little more space, but I still didn't want it to look cluttered, so I was trying to find a good balance, and I think that that wall was a good place to put like a desk and a computer. I'm trying to find a good wall color. I wanted to use like a light yellow because I was using a lot of blue in this build, and I thought that the yellow would complement the blue, or not complement, but I guess contrast the blue, so it would be a nice little effect. But yeah, the yellow was looking it was looking like it was like pea stained. It didn't look good. Like, it just looked like it was old and tattered, and yeah, I was not about that, so I just decided to make it, you know, a basic grayish whitish color. So yeah, I was also contemplating making the floors white because I liked the minimalistic look, but then I thought, like, you know, it's way too much white. You definitely need some more colors throughout the build, so I decided to change it to like a standard wood flooring. But again, if you guys feel like you want to change any of this, like, feel free. I'm definitely not the best builder. I was just trying to make the house, you know, have the necessities. So everything that you could need is there, but if you want to add other things or remove things, like, feel free. So right now I'm just trying to add some more clutter just to make the house look a little homey, look a little more lived in, and just to add a little more realism to this build. It's not much, just because of the the limit I have with money, and as you can see, I'm starting to approach the 20,000 simoleon limit, so I'm just trying to add a little bit here and there just to make the house a little more alive, but still trying to restrain myself because I don't want to go over that limit. I am adding the overhead to the stove just to, I think that adds a lot of realism because most houses have that, and they are amazing. They get rid of all the smells in your house, which is great, especially if you're like me and you always use onions in your cooking. Like, awesome. The overhead on your stove is amazing because it just gets rid of all of your smells. So great. I love it. Right now I'm just trying to add some more decoration again just to make the house look a little homey, because like my house is, like I've said, like, I don't really like decorating when I just play the game. Like, I obviously do it when I have to build a set, but just in game I never really decorate much just because I feel like it's a waste of time and it doesn't really affect me anyway. But like, it does now, like, after playing the game for a while and when I've started to add clutter, it does definitely make a difference. But I definitely would not spend as much time as I am right now on clutter. But yeah, my house is now finished, mostly. Now I'm just adding a little bit of decorations outside. So I just add a little barbecue and I add a bench for your Sims to sit on and eat some wieners if they're into that. But yeah, this house is essentially complete. I'm just doing some last finishing touches, adding a couple of trees just to make the house look a little more vibrant. And yeah, this is really the house. Now I'm going to show you the final product, and I hope you enjoy.